Alright, welcome to another video, and before we get started, I'd like to take a quick minute to thank all the Patreon supporters and YouTube channel members whose names you see scrolling across the screen right now. They make this financially possible, and without you, I probably wouldn't be here making videos, so thank you. Alright, so we're ready to get going with another quick flight today. I'm going to be testing a few somewhat relevant, some minor changes, and I'll explain those along the way. Go ahead and show you my GPS. Like we always do. You see there, we've just took off. You can ignore that long straight line. That's just where my GPS was kind of wandering around, getting a lock before I took off. But yeah, we're pretty much ready to go. So I'm going to go ahead and switch to cruise mode here in a bit. We'll let it complete this loiter. You might notice my AHI is actually level with the horizon now in the roll axis. It's not rolling more than the actual horizon was, like I mentioned in the last video, which is something I had noticed since switching to the HD system. Wait for the plane to come around here and kind of get on course, and then we'll finish explaining that. So I'm going to go back to cruise mode right about now. Actually went to the wrong mode. I'm going to fly by wire. Went to fly by wire. I'm going to go to cruise. So as you can see now, though, when I bank the plane, the AHI follows the horizon correctly. It doesn't roll at the wrong rate. Anyway, I mentioned in the last video, at the end of the last video, that I had read in the release notes for a future version of Ardupilot that would be a fix that was incorporated. I was actually wrong about that. It was a custom build of Ardupilot that I was reading the notes for when I read that. So once I figured out that I had made that mistake and it wasn't actually in the official main Ardupilot build, I brought it up to one of the developers that I know and asked if it could be pulled into the main release. And a short time later, he sent me this test build that I'm flying right now, which is a nightly build of 4.4.0 from a few days ago when I brought this up with that other extra change also added. It basically corrects the aspect ratio for using on the HD screen and makes the AHI follow the horizon correctly. So big thank you to him for that. So, it's, like I said, that's just one of the little minor things that we wanted to kind of correct, and I already took care of that. If it's not in the nightly builds of Ardupilot, by the time this video gets uploaded, it will be soon. I'll put a link to the PR, which is the pull request that mentions it, if you want to kind of keep up with that. But anyway, hopefully we're not going to have any flickering OSD. Which is a big thing that's bothered me since I started flying the Walksnail system. As you might know, if you've kept up with my comments and progress along the way, it's really bugged me the whole time since day one. And I think a lot of other people too. We just kind of happened to stumble across a workaround for it, I guess you could say. And to stop the OSD flickering with Walksnail, all you have to do is turn off recording on the video receiver. If you notice my recording icons in the top right corner of my screen right now, I'm recording on the video receiver. I might have said that wrong a minute ago. You have to turn off the recording on the video transmitter, onboard recording, onboard the airplane, is the one that you need to switch off to stop the flickering OSD. But basically, once you turn on off that recording in the video transmitter, you don't have any flickering anymore with the OSD. At least not anywhere near to the degree that it was doing previously. And that's kind of the reason I'm doing this little 2-mile run out to this corner of the woods right here that we've flown so many times in the earlier Walksnail videos. I think it's quite evident by now that flying this path out here results in a flickering OSD with the other setup. And another reason, there's an animal trap right down here somewhere that I wanted to kind of fly over and take a look at. I noticed it previously on one of my previous flights. I don't see it right now, though, unless it's in that shadowed area and I just can't see it from up here. I know there it is, the big round trap right there. I noticed that in one of my previous flights, and I just wanted to fly over it again and see if there was anything in there. But if you might notice, we have no flickering OSD. And that was actually pointed out in the comments on my last video. I'll overlay that on the screen right now. Well, during editing, I'll put it on the screen, but it'll be here for you right now. I had noticed it, and like I said, he pointed it out in the comments. And we started asking around in the Discord group for Walksnail. And a couple of other people tried it and kind of had similar results. And so we started playing around with it. And I was able to reproduce the flickering OSD on the bench by simply manually starting a recording in the video transmitter. Now you saw a quick little flicker right there. Like I said, it's not still 100% perfect. You do still have little minor glitches here and there, but I would say it's definitely 100% improved, and I would say it's 99.9% perfect. But what I was saying, I was able to actually reproduce this many times over at will on the workbench by simply starting a recording in the video transmitter. And I can do that whether armed or disarmed, in standby mode or not, doesn't matter. And the interesting thing is when you stop that recording, the flickering continues until you format the video transmitter storage. So I think there's definitely something related there, but being a closed source system, there's really no one that can look at it and give us any good info other than the Walksnail developers themselves. Looking down here, trying to figure out what this white stuff is in the edge of the weeds there. Can't really make it out. Might just be some feed or something like that. But, I've been talking to at least one person that's in direct contact with the Walksnail developers and kind of feeding back what we've been able to find and reproduce. And hopefully it'll lead to some positive changes in the future firmware. But for now, I'm 100% happy with just turning off that recording in the video transmitter, because like I said, I just kind of accidentally stumbled across that because I had already decided to disable that recording. Because as we found in the previous videos, it's only good for about 18 minutes of flight. So I just didn't find it useful anyway. So I just switched it off and wasn't going to use it. And I noticed after switching it off that the flickering stopped. So we started playing around and was able to confirm that that is directly related. So anyway, hopefully that'll lead to something positive in the future. And the only other, change as far as my airplane setup that's worth mentioning is the, pan servo. I finally got it changed. You know, I noticed my pan is a lot smoother now, especially if I take the time to try to move it smooth intentionally with a control. The biggest improvement is it doesn't jitter anymore. It stays where I put it. So again, that's a JX9180MG servo that I replaced the old FPV180 servo from Ready-Made RC. That was their old first version, probably from a decade ago. I don't even remember when I bought it. It's just something that was in my box of spare parts that I tried to use and basically just reminded myself why it ended up in there. But, I've already made that little run out to 10 miles like I want it and confirmed that the OSD is much more stable. And I hope this is useful for the Walksnail development team. And I know the AHI matches the actual horizon now if I set my tilt axis properly. We can verify that. You notice as we bank the airplane, the horizon matches the real horizon. The artificial horizon matches the real horizon perfectly, as you'd want. And if we roll the other way, you'll see it does the same that way. So I guess the only thing left to do is to enjoy the flight. And for that, we're going to go ahead and drop fly by wire A. Cut some power and lose some altitude. Get down low, do a little bit of low flying on the way back. We'll go make a low pass over the cows anyway. Yeah, there's a lot of hay bales out here, but the cows are mostly out closer to the fence this way. And another reason for getting down low like this, I want to intentionally get down to where my signal is going to be less than ideal and see if the OSD will start to drop out any. But honestly, we're still holding like 12 megabits per second. I doubt we're going to be able to get the signal down too low. But that said, we will, there's 5 megabits, there's my red warning, and the OSD is still stable. So let me go ahead and try to intentionally get down low. Maybe behind the shed. I just want to make it a point not to fly directly at it in case we should lose RC link. We don't want the airplane to try to return to home through the top of that shed, which would obviously not be fun. But yeah, we're still holding like 25 megabits bit rate right here. Kind of makes me wonder if we could fly through that shed, but we're definitely not going to do it today. I know I've said that numerous times in the past that I wasn't going to do it, and then I turned around and flew through it anyway. Excuse me, had to cough there. But we're definitely not going to fly through it today. I will make some low passes out here, though. Obviously, we have plenty of battery left. And I'm just kind of trying to experiment a little bit with low signal. Getting the signal low intentionally, getting the bitrate low to see how the video and the OSD behaves. Let's fly out towards this vehicle and see what they're up to. Obviously, they're just driving down the road, but it'll give us a point to fly it to anyway. And that will also kind of get me farther north where the signal probably will start to drop out a bit right up in this area. Alright, so let's start to wander back out this way, maybe. Maybe we can just get down low and fly along the road out here. And obviously you can see the road is really nasty out here. It's a mess. All the rain and everything we've been getting lately is not helping things very much. So there's a little stand of trees coming up right up here. I need to make sure we clear the tree line on the left side of the road, as well as the one on the right side. Obviously, we don't want to hit any of those. Yeah, it's pretty interesting that we can fly down low like this out here without really hurting the signal much. Even when we're intentionally trying to get a low quality signal out here, it's kind of tough to do. So I guess we're just going to kind of make a low run out here and head back home and consider it a success. I do want to get down low behind the shed, though, on purpose. I just have to watch the fences. There are fences out here. I don't want to try to run through one of those. I'm pretty positive I could make it through that shed if I wanted to. We might make a couple of more runs along the side of it, but we're definitely not flying through it. I keep saying that, but we're definitely not going to do it. But I do want to get down low and try to get the signal to cut back a little bit. Although I did get the low signal warning at that one point. I had the red bars flashing, or the red outline anyway. around the perimeter of the video flashing to indicate that the signal was low enough to the point where it's suggesting you turn back. You know, if you were flying manually or quad without return to home or something like that, that's kind of their point that you need to return, that you need to turn around anyway. And we still had a good OSD at that point, so I'm pretty happy with that. So I'm actually going to intentionally try to get down below this little stand of trees to our left. And yeah, there's some sketchy video, and it's actually a little tough to fly through. We gained a little altitude and got the video right back. And we can probably push down again. Yeah, you see all the compression coming in. We're down to 1 megabit, got the warning. A little bit of flicker in the OSD, which indicates that the signal for it is dropping out. It's losing data. But as soon as the video comes back, the OSD is stable again. So yeah, I would consider that a definite success as far as getting the OSD more stable, looking like it should. And just for fun, I want to try to fly down behind here. Yeah, this would easily be flyable. Fly through there. Gonna buzz these cows here. And head back home. So I've seen everything I wanted to see. And hopefully you have as well. Hopefully it's been enjoyable. And like I said, hopefully this helps out the development team for Walksnail that's gonna hopefully be looking into the OSD stuff. But regardless, even at the current state, I'm totally happy flying with it the way it is. At least now we have an option to get a good, stable, workable OSD that's not annoyingly flashing and flickering, dropping elements all over the screen the whole time we're flying. So, if the flashing, flickering OSD is bugging you as well, switch off your onboard recording for the time being, and it should fix it. And this is with the latest firmware, the 32 point whatever. It's the only one that starts with 30 something in the firmware. It's the latest beta. And you can get that from the Walksnail Discord. So we're going to fly home and land, and that'll be the end of the video. See how close we can get it to stop next to the tripod. Don't want to hit the tripod though, obviously. And we're probably going to come up short because I'm already starting my flare. And yeah, we came up short this time, trying to make it a point to land close. But yeah, there's the tripod sitting right there. So I'm going to go ahead and disarm, drop into low power mode. Disarmed. And everything looks good. Pretty happy with the progress we've made as far as figuring out the OSD stuff and getting something that works for the time being, and maybe get it resolved in the future. And the AHI looks better now, and the pan servo works better now, and I don't know, just making progress. So see you all in the next video, whenever that happens to be.